Hi friends, in our earlier videos I have introduced you how to prepare the trading account and the P&L account. In this video we'll learn about the closing entries which are actually passed for the preparation of the trading account and the P&L account. Let us start with the entries relating to the trading account. The entries we pass for transfer of direct expenses to the trading account. These are the entries we pass. We debit trading account. Trading account is debited. And the following accounts are credited to opening stock. This is the stock of unsold goods at the beginning of the last year, at the end of the last year, and stock of unsold goods at the beginning of the year to purchases. So whatever is there in the balance of this account, that amount has to be transferred to the trading account. To wages. Wages paid to the workers who are involved in loading, unloading the goods or for manufacturing or some making some changes to the goods. Carriage inward is the expenditure incurred for transporting the goods from the supplier's godowns to our godown. So it is like a transportation expenses when we purchase the goods. To freight inward, carriage inward. Freight is used when we pay shipping companies for transport of the goods. Carriage inward when we use road transport, freight inward. Then you can have fuel expenses. So again, fuel expenses for transporting the goods. So these expenses are transferred to the debit side of the trading account. So when we pass this entry, trading account is debited with all these accounts. And these accounts in the background are already showing debit balance. By passing this entry, these account gets closed and their balances get transferred to the trading account. Then we have one more entry relating to transfer of sales to the trading account. Sales is the income we generate by selling the goods. So sales account is debited and it is transferred to the credit side of the trading account. We'll pass the entry sales account at R2 trading account. So this is the entry we pass. Sales account is showing a credit balance. The account is debited to close it and it is transferred to the trading account. I can write the headings also. Write transfer of DE here means direct expenses. And this is transfer of direct incomes for the business. Next. We have to make some adjustments for purchase returns. Entry for purchase returns. So what is the entry we pass for purchase returns? As purchases account has already been debited to the trading account, purchase returns has to be subtracted from purchases. So what we do is we pass an entry purchase returns account debit to purchases account. This is the entry we pass. Purchase returns account is debited because it shows a credit balance. To close the account, we are debiting purchase returns and the amount is transferred to purchase account. Okay. Then entry for sales returns. Sales returns account shows a debit balance because it is an expense for the business. It would be showing a debit balance. To close the sales returns account, we would have to credit it and we would have to debit it to the sales account. Sales account is debited and sales returns account is credited. Sales returns account is showing a credit balance. Sales returns account shows a debit balance. To close it, we are going to credit the account. Okay. And sales account is debited. So as a result of these entries, and we pass one more entry, entry for closing stock. Closing stock of unsold goods. So first we have to find out how many goods are left unsold at the end of the year. We have to find their value and we have to pass an entry for closing stock. Closing stock entry is closing stock account at R2 trading account. This is the entry we pass. In our earlier videos, we have discussed why closing stock account is credited to the trading account. The logic is the cost of goods purchased during the year and expense incurred for those goods has already been debited to the trading account. Out of these expenses, there are certain expenses relating to goods which are remaining unsold. So the expense which have already been debited to the trading account has to be removed by crediting the trading account. All our earlier accounts are getting closed by transferring them to the trading account, but this is one account which takes birth in the trading account. So closing stock is an account which takes birth in the trading account, whereas all other accounts, sales returns, purchases, purchase returns, wages, carriage inward, freight inward, they're all getting closed by transfer to the trading account, whereas closing stock takes birth in the trading account. When we credit the trading account, when we debit the closing stock account starts to show a balance which will be carried to the balance sheet. Okay. Entry for gross profit. When the trading account credit side is more than the debit side, we get the gross profit. Or we said when sales minus cost of goods sold is positive, it is gross profit. Entry for gross profit. Now, what do we do with the gross profit? If there is a balance left in the trading account, it has to be transferred to the P&L account. We pass the entry trading account debtor to profit and loss account with the amount of gross profit. So if we have gross profit with that entry, we are going to pass this entry. If there is a loss, entry for gross loss. If there is a loss, that means trading account debit side is more than the credit side. Then in such case, we have a loss. The loss has to be transferred to the debit side of the P&L account. So we'll write P&L account debtor to trading account if there is a loss. Entry for gross loss. Now using these entries, we are going to prepare our trading account once again. We already know the format. We'll again prepare the trading account here for you. Trading account of a trader for year ended 31st March 21. Debit, credit, particulars, rupees and rupees, inner column and outer column, particulars, rupees and rupees. So if you see the first closing entry we passed, we said trading account has to be debited to opening stock, to purchases, to wages, to carriage inward. If you post this entry in this ledger account, we'll write here to opening stock, to purchases, we'll write it in the inner column because we have one purchase returns entry which is asking us to credit purchase account. Crediting purchase account is equal to reducing the balance. That is why we show it here directly, and the net purchase is shown in the outer column. So here we are saying purchase returns account has to be debited and purchase account has to be credited. Purchase account normally shows a debit balance. That means this entry is asking you to reduce the balance of the purchase account. The same thing we are doing in the trading account directly. To wages, to carriage inward, to freight inward, to fuel expenses. Now, actually, the total of all these expenses is called as cost of goods which are available for sale. So during the year, let us say 1100 or 2000 goods were available for sale. This is the cost incurred for these 2000 goods. Out of these cost, if you remove the cost relating the goods which are remaining unsold, we will be left with cost of goods sold. That has to be matched to sales to arrive at gross profit or loss. So to find out the cost of goods sold, this is the cost of goods which are available for sale, the cost of the goods which could have been sold during the year. I credit the trading account with closing stock figure by closing stock. This is the value of the goods which are remaining unsold. If you see the entry for closing stock, what was the entry for closing stock? We passed closing stock account at R to trading account. I'm just giving a posting now here. So I'm writing here by closing stock. Now what happens is, out of the cost of goods which are available for sale during the year, we are putting some amount on the credit side. That means we are saying, out of these expenses, this is the amount of expense relating to goods which are unsold. By crediting it, actually we are subtracting it from these amounts. Or we could have said minus closing stock here. Instead of writing minus closing stock, we are writing it on the credit side so that we arrive at the cost of the goods which have been sold. Okay. So this portion is nothing but the cost of goods sold. So this portion in the trading account actually represents the cost of goods sold. Okay. Or you can show this here in less also, but that is not how we prepare the trading account format. Now, what we'll do is, we'll put the remaining entries also in the trading account and try to close the trading account to arrive at the gross profit. Then we go and credit the trading account with sales, buy sales, inner column, less sales returns. We have passed an entry for sales returns, where sales return account has to be credited and sales account has to be debited. Sales account shows a credit balance. If you are asking sales account to be debited, that means you want to reduce the balance in the sales account. That is why we are writing sales returns as less in the trading account. Now we calculate the gross profit of the business. How do we arrive at the gross profit? We total the credit side, subtract the debit side. The gross profit is transferred to the P&L account, or we'll simply write to P&L account. This is the amount of gross profit. This is nothing but the balancing figure. B by F means balancing figure. This is the amount we have to put so that both the sides will become equal. If there is a gross loss, we'll write by P&L account, there will be gross loss. By P&L account, if there is a gross loss, so this is how we prepare the trading account. If you write to P&L account, P&L account will show by trading account. If you write by P&L account, trading account will show to P&L account. So if there is a gross profit, it will be credited to the P&L account. If there is a gross loss, it will be debited to the profit and loss account. So this is how we prepare the trading account, by writing the closing entries. I hope you are able to understand the closing entries. In our next video, we'll see what are the closing entries we pass for preparation of the profit and loss account.